Hello friends, let us now deal with the other side of the rotation. So now this side we are going to have left hand side, and this left hand side indicates that there is a clockwise movement with respect to cyclic values. Suppose if I say that I have an input array in this fashion, say 12, 9, 4 and 8, the output array has to be shifting towards left hand side. So it means that the first element has to be 9. The next element has to be 4, the next element has to be 8, and then the last element has to be 12. Now, if you say that you are going to copy this element 8 to the next position, then this to the next position, then this to the next position, it means that you are going to copy 8 at all the places. The one which I have stated in the previous video is going to be the much simpler one. Let us check whether the previous algorithm which I have stated in the previous video will work for this situation also not. So, as for that, the very first step is what? Yes, you remember it properly. I had to say that I had to shift the elements towards left hand side of one position. It means that one element is going to go out. The element which is going to go out should always be copied into temp. In this, when I shift the elements towards left hand side, A of 0 goes to temp. So, your temp is now copied as A of 0. In this case, temp is what? 12. Right? Now, A of 0 goes to temp. So now I don't have regrets if someone overwrites 12. So I have to identify an index next to this or prior to this. As such, I don't have an index prior to this. I have index next to this. That is at 9. And move to the other side, that is n minus 1. So I have to start from I equals to 1 and go till n minus 1. So A of I is 1. Where you used to copy this particular A of 1? A of 1, I need to copy it onto A of 0. So, A of I, that is 1, should go to A of 0, that is I minus 1. Keep on doing this task till you reach to the last element. So, when I is n minus 1, substitute n minus 1 over here. I is n minus 1, A of n minus 1. A of n minus 1 is 8. 8 gets copied at A of n minus 1 minus 1, that is n minus 2. So, 8 gets copied to the next position. At the end of step number 2, I'll have all the elements shifted except the last two. The last two both are 8 itself. And the third step is to suffix this particular temp to the last location. Since it has went out from A of 0, I'll say A of n minus 1. So, I have copied the elements by multiple positions or by one position towards what? Left hand side. Three simple steps to remember. One, say that copy the first element onto temp. Start with the index next to that towards the end, shift all the elements towards left hand side by one position, that is A of I should be transferred to A of I minus 1. A of 1 should go to 0, 2 should go to 1, 3 should go to 2, 4 should go to 3 and so on, n minus 1 should go to n minus 2. So in general, A of I should go to A of I minus 1. And then since the element has taken out from A of 0, it should get fixed at A of n minus 1, and that is in temp. Let's look at the code and understand this with a number set of numbers also. The concepts we just spoke, assume numbers n as say 5. Read the numbers 12, 9, 7, 4, say 8. Now, I'll shift these elements towards left hand side by one position. So, I'll write this array and this is my output array. So, what it says, A of 0 should be copied onto temp. So, temp will become 12. A of 0 goes to temp. So, this is 0. 1, 2, 3, 4. So, I have to start the loop from what to what? 1 to n minus 1. So, 1 to n minus 1 is from this location towards this n minus 1. So, A of 1 should go to A of 1. When I is 1, A of 1 should go to A of 0. So, A of 1 comes to A of 0. That is 9. So, 9 goes to this location. Go back. I plus plus. I becomes 2. A of 2 should go to A of 1. That is 7. Then I becomes 3. A of 3 should go to A of 2, that is 4. Then finally, at one time I becomes 4. A of 4 goes to A of 3, this is 8. When you go back, I plus plus will increase the value of I to 5, which means that it is quit. When I quit, whatever the value which is in temp, since it has been taken out from A of 0, should go to the other end, that is A of n minus 1. So temp goes to A of 1, A of n minus 1, that is 12. Don't you feel that the elements of an array has been shifted by one position towards left hand side? I moved in a clockwise direction if I say rotation of the array. If asked to do it for multiple times, again, embed this particular entire stuff into a for loop. So finally, display the modified array as for I equals 0, I less equal to n minus 1, I plus plus, printf percentage d slash n comma a of I. So here, we are going to shift the elements of an array by multiple times. If I say that I'm supposed to do it for, say, shift to 2 times, then this body which I've stated has to be there in a for loop as for, say, k equals to 1, k less than equals to 2, k plus plus. And then the entire body has to be placed inside this particular k loop, which means that the elements need to be shifted by 2 times. If I had to say for 3 times, k equals to 1, k less than equals to 3. So right shifting and then left shifting. We have done both the programs separately. The logic still remains same. In the previous video, we have seen how exactly the contents of an array are shifted to the right hand side. So visualize, one element goes out, copy it onto temp, shift the remaining elements one by one, starting with the index either prior or after that, and then go to the other end and manually refix that particular element. If it has to be done for multiple times, the entire body has to be placed in one more new for loop, which is for the number of times the operation need to be carried out. I hope these two programs are clear, and these two programs are going to be the most important programs of this particular arrays. Thank you.